greet you in the name of our risen Lord and Savior Jesus Christ as I share this message today that will have been preached in the sanctuary of Woodlawn United Methodist Church. I welcome all of you who are viewing this service online, and we are connected to you vitally and want you to know our love and care is with you, as well as our congregation who were able to be in worship in the sanctuary. I am reading from the Gospel according to St. Matthew, and you may rise as you are able where you are. I begin with the first verse of the 13th chapter. That same day, Jesus went out of the house and sat beside the sea. Such great crowds gathered around him that he got into a boat and sat there, while the whole crowd stood on the beach. And he told them many things in parables, saying, "Listen, a sower went out to sow. And as he sowed, some seeds fell on the path, and the birds came and ate them up. Other seeds fell on rocky ground, where they did not have much soil, and they sprang up quickly, since they had no depth of soil. But when the sun rose, they were scorched, and since they had no root, they withered away. Other seeds fell among thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked them. Other seeds fell on good soil and brought forth grain, some 100-fold, some 60, some 30. Let anyone with ears listen." This is the word of life. Thanks be to God. As we focus today on this parable, it might very well be, first of all, that we understand the concept of why Jesus preached and taught in parables. In the time of Christ, for him to speak with authority was a threat to the religious authorities of his day. The words that he would use then would need to be such that they would speak to his hearers without imposing upon him the threat of those authorities that might be listening to him if he were to misquote the Old Testament, or if he were in any way in his words were to be a threat to the religious traditions that those authorities represented. And so he used the common and the everyday. An image that will be available to you who are worshiping with us online, as well as was available in the sanctuary, that has been a touchstone for this message, is a painting by Vincent van Gogh. Van Gogh is one of my favorite artists. He painted a series of paintings around this story of the sower. One of them is The Sower at Sunset, which was painted in 1888. I remind you that Van Gogh began as a clergyman. He served a Methodist church in England. As a young man, he felt the calling into ministry, and his only appointment to a church was outside of London. As he stood to preach, Van Gogh was not one we would have classified as a great public speaker. He nervously would stumble over his words, but the substance of his message, as those who heard it, was impressive. Another problem that Van Gogh had was he was not particularly social. His appearance was scruffy to those who would have encountered him in that little church outside of London. And needless to say, his ministry there was not effective, because those who were a part of his flock could not appreciate the person that Van Gogh was. And so he took up painting. And we are thankful that he did. Starry, Starry Night, which inspired has been a touchstone for me as I have prepared this message today is referred to as the sower at sunset. Now, when you look at that image, you will see that the sower is casting forth the seed, sowing the seed, out in a field that is radiant at sunset. The sower himself appears in such a way in the painting that he looks naturally a part of the landscape. The palette of this painting, the colors are rich, as they often are in Van Gogh's presentations. But one gets a very real sense, as one looks at this painting, of how this sower has a high calling. Now, as we look at the parable that Jesus shared, the parable of the sower, we're often apt to focus more on the seed than we are the sower, because we have great detail about where the seed fell on the path. The birds came. Other seeds fell on rocky ground. Other seeds fell amongst the thorns. Other seeds were scorched and withered away. And then the seeds that fell on good soil. And we're apt, I think, when we hear this parable, to focus more on being the seeds and making sure that we're falling in the right place in terms of God's plan for us, than we are to focus on the sower. As we read this parable, Barbara Brown Taylor, a great friend of mine and one of the great preachers of our time, has reminded us, by speaking in parables, Jesus could get his message across without saying it directly, so that his followers nodded and smiled while his critics would have scratched their heads. He speaks in parables, he says, so that only certain kinds of listeners can hear him. Those who listen less with their minds and more with their hearts. Now, as we focus on this parable today, the title of my message is, When Love Gets Sown. That's really the calling that we have in relationship to being sowers. And we're to be extravagant in the way that we sow that love. Just as we read in this parable that this sower extravagantly cast forth the seed. We have all of these occasions when the seeds were sown in this parable. We need to focus and meditate on how we are being extravagant in the way we are sowing forth love in these desperate days. We are challenged in this time of social distancing. It's difficult for us to even connect with our own family members, much less others. And yet the power of the grace of God and the love of Christ is such that there are no real obstacles through the power of the Holy Spirit that can overcome those obstacles. So often in the church, as the body of Christ, we have cloistered ourselves away in such a way within the walls of the church that we find ourselves separated from the world around us. We see and read, as you see in the image of the Van Gogh painting, and as you hear in the reading of this parable, that this sower was extravagant in casting forth the seed. He went beyond his calling to send forth the seed wherever they would fall. So we must be inspired through the power of the Holy Spirit to cast forth our seed in such a way as the body of Christ, that the love of Christ will fall wherever that seed is cast forth. One of my favorite books is Annie Dillard's Pilgrim at Tinker Creek. Very similar to Thoreau in going to Wall Taylor finds herself in the mountains of Appalachia. And she spends a year there recording what becomes this book, Pilgrim at Tinker Creek. She is intentional in the way that she has set herself apart from the world and retreated from the burdens of everyday life in order to be a part of nature. And her book is a record of that journey into the natural world. One of the things that she so beautifully reminds us of in her book is this. As I look at the landscape, it's an extravagant gesture. It is the very extravagant gesture that is the very stuff of creation. Our God is an awesome God. He's also an extravagant God. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. Not just Augusta, Georgia, not just Richmond County, not just Woodlawn United Methodist Church. For God so loved the world. God in the extravagance of his love and his grace and forgiveness is calling us to be equally extravagant. Now I think so often we are afraid of extravagance as Christians, and there are areas we do not need to be extravagant in. I think that this time of pandemic is teaching all of us lessons about what our real priorities must be. Things are those items that Jesus reminds us of that the moths can eat at. So the material things are taking a back seat, I think, more and more for many of us. But God, in his extravagant love, would inspire us in the extravagance of our love for his creation, for one another, for the very world around us. Van Gogh's life was in many ways a life marked by suffering and pain. Much of it is attributed to now to physical issues that he had that may have also caused him to suffer mentally as well. But we have the great gifts of his painting. And in this painting of the sower at sunset, we see the extravagance of the artist in the colors, in the palette, but also in the emotion of the figure presented there. The extravagance that you are called to, that I am called to, that the body of Christ here at Woodlawn United Methodist Church is called to, means that when love gets sown, there is no end to it. And that love, the love of Jesus Christ, must be sown in and through us, even now. Let it be so. Let it be so. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the people who are Woodlawn say, amen.